Welcome back to another edition of The Grind, your inside look at raging Cajun baseball. I'm your host, Greg Larnard. All right, let's take a look back at what the Cajuns did last week. They were home to Wright State, game one. They dropped 8-2. Jack Burke a little ineffective. Once again, the offense really couldn't get things rolling, and they came up short in that game. Game two, however, Nick Lee pitched well again. The Cajuns got the win 6-3, thanks to Ken Fontenot, his two RBI safety squeeze slash suicide squeeze. Ended up getting two RBIs out of that. That was the difference in that game. And then it came down to game three. The Cajuns trailing 3-2 in the bottom of the seventh. Runner on, Daniel LeHair hits one deep to right field. Is it off the wall or is it gone? Umpire comes in, calls it a home run. Everybody scores, the Cajuns are happy. 4-3 lead in the bottom of the seventh. And then they get together, the umpires do, and they reverse the call, put runners back on second and third. It's still 3-2 Raiders. Coach Robe, none too happy about that. And needless to say, he got the old heave-ho and he was thrown out of the game and he will be suspended for two games. They end up having second and third, nobody outs, and not able to do anything with it. They end up losing the game 4-3. It was a real heartbreaker for the Cajuns. And now on Wednesday, they had to kind of regroup quickly. Colt Schmidt took the mound, and he pitched really, really well. He pitched deep into this ball game, didn't walk a single batter, only allowed 5 hits. Although the Cajuns, they got no hit through 5.5 innings until Daniel LeHair was able to drop a single, or double, excuse me, into left field. The Cajuns were able to just get enough offense in this one to prevail against Nichols 2-1. Speaking of Daniel LeHair, let's look at our grinder of the week. And it is Daniel LeHair. Man, I'll tell you, he is a very hard-nosed, intense type of player. If you had to kind of build a just prototypical baseball player, Daniel LeHair would probably encapsulate that. He's a guy who plays with a lot of intensity, like I said, a lot of passion. He wears it on his sleeve. You see him get a single, a double, a big hit, he's pumped up. He's looking at the dugout, throwing his arms all over the place. That's the kind of intensity the Cajuns need. He seems to find his way on base every single time he gets up, or at the very least puts together a good at bat. All right, now let's take a look at what the Cajuns have coming up this weekend. They'll head to the Shriners Classic out at Minute Maid, home of the Houston Astros. Their opponent game one, SEC opponent Mississippi State. They are the number 21 team ranked in the nation. They're currently 3-5. They get off to a little bit of a slow start. They have 14 newcomers this year, a young team. Their former coach, Andy Catanzaro, 0-3 to start the season. A little bit of allegations of some certain different things kind of coming out about him. He's gone. Pitching coach Gary Henderson is now at the helm, and Mississippi State's been playing a little bit better. Game two for the Cajuns, they'll be facing another SEC opponent, number 12, Vanderbilt. They're 9-1 on the season. The offense has been absolutely on a tear this season. 9.5 runs per game. Lots of team speed as well. So Cole McKinnon behind the plate, you're gonna have to be ready. 30-for-32 on stolen bases this year. Look out for young freshman outfielder Pat DeMarco, who's having a very solid season. And for the third game, the Cajuns will be facing in the Shriner Classic, number 7 team in the nation, Kentucky. They're having a very good season, 8-1 on the year. Another very good offense. They're scoring over 8.5 runs per game. Big bat to look out for in this lineup will be sophomore DH Tyler Collette. He's having a big year, lots of home runs, 5 home runs, 17 RBIs. And for this weekend's games, every single game can be heard, of course, on KPL 96.5 and KPL 96.5. .com. Game one against Mississippi State kicks off at 7 o'clock. Game two, first pitch is at 3:30 p.m. And then game three is a matinee against Kentucky at 11. It's going to be a good weekend for the Cajuns out in Houston. Go Cajuns, and we'll catch you next time on The Grind, your inside look at raging Cajun baseball. If you're enjoying The Grind so far, make sure you give this video a big thumbs up in every single video that we have here on our ESPN 1420 YouTube page. And speaking of that, why don't you keep up with us? Subscribe to our YouTube page. Ton of great content from the Raging Cajuns, the Pelicans, high school football, everything. We've got it here for you on ESPN 1420.